Hi and a very good evening to all of you. Welcome back to our daily current affairs videos. I hope aap sabka preparation acha chal raha hai. You all are healthy and fine and fully into your RBI grade B preparation. Each day counts, right? Every single day counts. You have to win yourself each day. You have to win over your targets every single day. All right? So I hope the practice sessions and everything is going well. You can directly contact with our mentors and our team, who is always ready and there to help you out. All right? You can also have a look at our RBI grade B crash course, right? It will help you. It will help you ace your preparation. It will help you assess whether your preparation is going in the right direction or not. And if not, it is still time. It is still time to start preparing under the right direction, under the right guidance, right? And that is why the name of this course is RBI Crash Course, to help you equip yourself, to help equip you guys, you know, prepare better and perform better in the actual examination. All right, so just do have a look at our crash course, and to get access to the PDF of these daily current affairs videos, you can join our Telegram channel, from where you can download the PDF of this session. Alright, so the link of our Telegram channel will be given down in the description below, so do check it out. Alright, so moving on to the very first question of today. Which IIT has developed India's first made in India polycentric prosthetic knee named as Kadam? Alright, so polycentric prosthetic knee. प्रोस्थेटिक नी बेसिकली एक तरह का मेडिकल इम्प्लांट हो गया, जैसे आपके हार्ट में स्टेंट्स लगते हैं, राइट? हिप रिप्लेसमेंट सर्जरीज होती है. लाइकवाइज प्रोस्थेटिक नी इज ऑल्सो अ टाइप ऑफ अ मेडिकल इम्प्लांट. ऑल राइट, एंड एज यू ऑल नो दैट इन द ईयर 2020 द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट अनाउंस दैट ऑल द मेडिकल डिवाइसेज एंड मेडिकल इम्प्लांट्स विल बी कैटेगराइज एज ड्रग्स. As drugs, इनको क्यों categorize किया गया? So that they can be monitored, their prices can be monitored by the CDSO. All right, so this is the main thing behind the medical implants, right? Of which prosthetic knee is very very important. One of the most important, सबसे ज़्यादा surgery knee replacement surgeries की होती है, right? So this is India's first polycentric prosthetic knee, right? So which IIT has developed it, and its name, the polycentric prosthetic knee ka jo name hai, it is named as Kadam. So answer the question correctly. Which IIT has developed Kadam polycentric prosthetic knee? The correct answer here is IIT Madras. All right, so IIT Madras has first made in India polycentric prosthetic knee. All right, so this is very very important. So basically in regulations ka yahi fayda hota hai, that by classifying medical implants as drugs, they now come under the regulations of CDSO. All right, their prices are regulated, and now that their prices are regulated, it gives a boost to startups, right, to all the innovators in the country to start manufacturing them. Why? Because now they know that they will be available at affordable price to the citizens, so that they can get an access to it. All right, so this is where governance also plays a very key and a crucial role in, you know, promoting welfare, right, in promoting private enterprise. All right, so this is one insight into it. Just think about it. All right, so IIT Madras has launched Kadam, right? It was developed by a team at TTK Center for Rehab Research and Device Development. Rehab Research and Device Development, ek research institute hai, right? It is headed by Professor Sujata Srinivasam. All right, so basically this Rehab Research and Device Development, R2D2, under Professor Sujata Srinivasam, its main aim is to conduct research regarding human mobility, right, and to find equipments that assist in human mobility, so that they can be made available to people in need at an affordable prices and simple technology. All right, so according to WHO, only 1 out of 10 people, only 1 out of 10 people have access to affordable, medical assistance, to access to affordable tools access to affordable tools that help in mobility. Right? Mobility को assist करने के लिए जो affordable tools है, only 1 out of 10 people in India have affordable access to it. So basic aim R2D2 का है to bridge this gap, right? To bridge this divide. Right, to eliminate this unaffordability criteria. All right, so all these assistive devices and movement impairment ka main aim is this is what the objective of R2D2 is. It is done in collaboration with Society for Biomedical Technology. All right, R2D2 ne haal hi mein do bahut hi important mobility instruments develop kiye hain. Number one is Arise. Arise is India's first standing wheelchair and NeoFly NeoBolt. All right, so NeoFly NeoBolt is also an active wheelchair. All right, isme it enables indoor outdoor mobility. Right, indoor outdoor mobility ko assist karne ke liye NeoFly NeoBolt develop kiya gaya hai. All right, so I hope the slide was clear to you. You understood whatever I told you, right? These innovations are very important, right? This is actually a very important slide. You should know. Aise science and technology ke andar questions aa sakte hain, right? Like which organization developed Arise or NeoFly NeoBolt, or a question can be asked that Arise in a statement form, that Arise was developed by R2D2, right? What is Arise related to, or what is NeoFly NeoBolt related to? So if a question on NeoFly NeoBolt comes up, it is an indoor outdoor mobility enhancing tool. All right, so R2D2 ke objectives bhi pooch sakte hain just in case. So I've told you all that, right? So question number 2 concerns you with which PSU has signed an incubation agreement with startup Om Clean Tech Private Limited for design. Om, you all know Om, it is a unit for electricity, right? कौन से PSU ने have signed an incubation agreement? Incubation agreement means the initial stages of developing, that developer agreement. All right, basically the initial stages of development, integration and development for 9M hydrogen fuel powered e-bus and liquid organic hydrogen LOHC solution. All right, so answer the question correctly first so that we can move on to the explanation. Okay, so the correct answer to this question is Oil, OIL, Oil India Limited, India ka sabse important public sector undertaking, right? It is owned by the government of India under the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. All right, so who is the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas? Mr. Hardeep Singh, right? Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri is the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, right? So Oil India Limited is also trying to implement Government of India's mission. Aap sabko pata hai that in the year 2021 the Government of India launched a National Hydrogen Mission. National Hydrogen Mission 2021 was launched, and the main aim of the mission was that the Indian hydrogen manufacturing should be enhanced. It should be enhanced to at least three-fourth of its non-renewable fuel, right? Three-fourth of its renewable fuel, right? By 2050, right? Or hydrogen ko as a renewable fuel use karna bahut bahut easy hai, right? Iske prospective वाकई में बहुत important है. Why? Because hydrogen is a fuel that produces only water and vapor when it is combusted. Secondly, very important, it is very very easy to store hydrogen. ठीक है, तो ये सारे factors हैं. Incubation agreement sign किया गया, liquid organic hydrogen carrier solution, startup will be mentored by IIT Guwahati. All right, and oil also sponsors startups under SNEH, right? Startup nurturing and enabling and hand holding. All right, so hydrogen fuel कैसे generate होता है? सबसे पहले we have also discussed about it in one of our previous lectures, but let's go through it again, right? Hydrogen undergoes electrolysis, right? And that process of electrolysis, it can be done, it is obviously electricity is used to perform electrolysis, इट इज क्वाइट ऑब्वियस गाइज, राइट? सो द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी दैट इज यूज, अगर वो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी रेन्यूएबल एनर्जी सोर्सेज से जनरेट हो रही है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल सोलर और विंड पावर, देन इट इज़ नोन एज ग्रीन हाइड्रोजन, राइट? अगर वो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी जनरेट हो रही है यूजिंग नेचुरल गैस, राइट, देन इट इज़ नोन एज ब्लू हाइड्रोजन. बट अगर वो कन्वेंशनल सोर्सेज से इलेक्ट्रिसिटी वो जनरेट हो रही है टू परफॉर्म इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस टू प्रोड्यूस हाइड्रोजन फ्यूल, राइट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल थर्मल पावर प्लांट, देन इट इज़ नोन एज ब्राउन हाइड्रोजन फ्यूल, राइट? सो दीज आर सम वेरी बेसिक थिंग्स, राइट? इट इज़ एक्सपेक्टेड ऑफ यू टू नो अबाउट इट वेन यू आर रीडिंग नेशनल हाइड्रोजन मिशन, वेन यू आर रीडिंग अबाउट आवर पॉलिसीज एंड स्कीम्स और सच, इवन सच न्यूज आइटम्स वेन यू आर रीडिंग, दीज आर सम वेरी बेसिक फैक्ट्स विच यू आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू नो, राइट? बिकॉज यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इट, यू आर अटेम्प्टिंग सच क्वेश्चन इन योर डेली एम सी क्यूज, right? You have to write it in the descriptive paper, so at least the basic concepts should be known. All right, so this was all to it, right? Oil ke headquarters kahan pe hai? Oil India Limited, this is the logo. Sometimes the logo can be asked, although very rare, but you must have a look at it, right? Oil, the chairman and MD of Oil India Limited is Mr. Sushil Chandra Mishra. Right, Sushil Chandra Mishra is the chairman and MD of Oil India Limited, right? And its headquarters in the is located in Assam, right? ये आप बहुत अच्छे से ध्यान रखिएगा कि दैट ऑयल इंडिया लिमिटेड के हेडक्वार्टर्स आर इन असम इन द सिटी ऑफ दिब्रूगढ़, राइट? दिब्रूगढ़ में बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट लोकेशन है, इंडिया की सबसे पहली ऑयल रिफाइनरी यूनिट इन डुलियागंज, इट वॉज सेटअप, right? Duliaganj, Assam, the India's first ever oil refinery unit. Please do read and learn more about it. This is where the headquarters of Oil India Limited are located. All right, so these are some key facts about Oil India Limited, hydrogen economy. All right, we have learnt about ye bahut hi important hai, SNE, startup nurturing and enabling and handholding. Ye Oil India ki scheme hai, right? SNE is also related to the towards the promotion of, you know, hydrogen fuel, right? And also high technology renewable energy sources, and all these factors are covered up. Basically, all these startups are promoted under the SNE program. All right. So liquid organic hydrogen carrier से आप लोग समझ के होंगे कि hydrogen fuel को carry करने वाला है कोई solution. All right. And of course, this is the startup with which an incubation agreement has been signed with. All right, so moving on to the next question, which state has launched Jan Arogya Mela? Jan Arogya Mela jo ki har Sunday ko organize kiya jayega by all the primary health centers of the state to provide free consultation and medicines to the people. Now answer the question first, very very easy question, right? Which state has organized or launched Jan Arogya Mela? The state of Uttar Pradesh. First Jan Arogya Mela, or known as Mukhyamantri Arogya Mela, was first launched in 2020. राइट, इट इज़ बींग रीस्टार्टेड नाउ. ऑलराइट, सो जन आरोग्य मेला में सिर्फ प्राइम फ्री कंसल्टेशन एंड मेडिसिन ही नहीं दिया जाएगा, बट ऑल्सो स्कीम्स, राइट? ऑल द स्कीम्स यू नो रिलेटेड टू हेल्थ इट विल बी प्रमोटेड टू द पीपल, राइट? जितने भी हेल्थ से रिलेटेड इम्पॉर्टेंट स्कीम्स हैं उनके बारे में अवेयरनेस जनरेट भी करेगा दिस जन आरोग्य मेला. विल ऑल्सो कैरी आउट एन अवेयरनेस जनरेशन प्रोग्राम रिगार्डिंग ऑल द स्कीम्स रिलेटेड टू हेल्थ. ऑलराइट, सो यूपी हैज़ बिकम, योगी आदित्यनाथ हैज़ ऑल्सो अनाउंस्ड अ 100 बेड हॉस्पिटल ईच ऑफ द 403 असेंबली सेगमेंट्स इन द स्टेट. एंड मोर देन दैट, if you want to know more, then also a golden health card, right? A golden health card will be given to all the you know, people who attend Jan Arogya Mela, and especially the beneficiaries of various government schemes. All right, so moving on to the next question, we have, where was the Air Force Commanders Conference 2022 held, right? Air Force Commanders Conference 2022 kahan pe conduct karaya gaya tha? राइट, आंसर द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट, जल्दी से आंसर करिए. The Air Force Commanders Conference was held in New Delhi, right? Vayu Bhavan. Right? It was conducted by Defense Minister Rajnath Singh, right? At headquarters of Air Force Office in New Delhi. The theme of the conference was optimizing human resources, right? Defense Minister launched Meher Baba competition too, right? Meher Baba competition, basically, it aims to, Meher Baba competition, basically, it is a competition to encourage all the startups in the drone technology, right? Drone technology mein jitne bhi startups invest karna chahe, aage badhna chahe, Meher Baba competition too is basically to give us push to all these startups, right? Other than that, also swarm drone based system to detect foreign object on aircraft operating services will also be developed. All right. Chief of Indian Air Force kaun hai? The Chief of Indian Air Force, Chief IAF Chief is Mr. Air Marshal. Whenever you write the name of IAF Chief, you always use Air Marshal Mr. Vivek Ram Chaudhary. Right, Vivek Ram Chaudhary is the chief of IAF, right? And also drone related threats will also be, you know, brainstormed. Jaise foreign countries, bordering nations mein jitne bhi drone related, you know, spying operations hote, all the threats that are you know, related to drone, mitigating the impacts will be brainstormed in the conference. All right. It is a very, very important conference. Usually it is conducted almost annually. All right. And you have to remember the place it was, you know, conducted in New Delhi Air Force headquarters. All right. So recently Asian Development Bank and Louis Dreyfus Company BV has signed a loan of up to $100 million to help smallholder farmer to recover from the impact of COVID-19. Of course, COVID-19 impact se, and especially climate change ke impact se, jitne bhi farmers ko trouble hua hai, to ADB and LDC have, you know, signed a loan of up to $100 million. All right, where is LDC headquartered? Right, LDC ke headquarters ka hai, jaldi se answer karke bataiye. Right, this is the LDC headquarters are in Netherlands. All right, Rotterdam, Netherlands. All right, a loan of $100 million has been signed to help smallholder farmers recover from the impact of COVID-19 pandemic and improve resilience to climate change impact. All right, so basically Asian Development Bank, let us know about the scheme first, right? Ye India, Indonesia, Pakistan, Thailand, Vietnam mein operate karega, and the crops that it will be concerning itself with is coffee, cotton, rice inventories, right? 50,000 smallholders, farmers will be benefited from the scheme, and India mein jin farmers ke upar focus kiya jayega, these are cotton farmers. Cotton farmers, can you tell me guys, what issues do cotton farmers play, right? India mein cotton usually dry areas mein, you know, grow kiya jata hai, like Maharashtra and Gujarat. All right, usually Maharashtra and Gujarat are famous for cotton harvesting, right? Cotton cultivation, because cotton does not need that much of a rainfall. So climate change, COVID-19 ka impact we all know, but climate change ka impact kya hai cotton mein? Sabse pehla impact hai insects, right? Bollworm and pink bollworm is a very important, matlab, it is a burning issue when it comes to crisis with cotton farmers. Usually, you know, farmers faces a lot of losses, right? Because using insecticides on these bollworm, you know, pests, it also destroys some of the crops as well, right? So इसी तरह cotton में और issue आ जाता है, जैसे BT cotton. BT cotton is basically you know, it is a GMO, right? It is a genetically modified crop. It is a genetically modified cotton, right? उसमें in the crop the resistance towards the bollworm infestation is already added. All right, but despite that also, right, then BT cotton also requires a lot of you know, extra care, a lot of more investments. All right, that is why cotton farmers are being targeted in India. All right. Asian Development Bank. We have also discussed about Asian Development Bank in one of our previous videos. There's no problem in going through it again and revising it. Asian Development Bank was formed in the year 1966. All right. It is headquartered in Manila. Right. It is its president is Masatsugu Asakawa. Right. Masatsugu Asakawa is the president of Asian Development Bank. Alright, and key focus area. It is very important to know the key focus area of Asian Development Bank. It definitely can be asked in the exam. I don't see a reason why it cannot be. So education, right? Climate change, disaster risk management, DRM, disaster risk management, financial sector ke development and infrastructure development. All these are some of the key areas in which Asian Development Bank, invests. And of course, private sector lending and regional cooperation and integration. It is very, very important. Why? Because it is Asian Development Bank, right? Asian Development Bank means Asia and Pacific are the key regions where it focuses its investments towards, right? And it is completely modeled on the World Bank, right? These are some of the key areas in which it lends or invests, right? Moving on to the next question we have, which insurance company has partnered with Common Service Centers under MeitY, right? Ministry of Electronics and IT, for selling its life insurance plan to rural household, right? Common Service Center, you all know, Common Service Centers are basically governance units. These were, first formed under National e-governance plan, right? National e-governance plan ke under Common Service Centers ko launch kiya gaya tha, and now Common Service Center since 2015 there was a phase 2 or a second phase of Common Service Center, right? Second phase of Common Service Center ensures that at least there is at least one Common Service Center in every Gram Panchayat in the country. How many Gram Panchayats are there in India? 2.5 lakh Gram Panchayats, right? In each of these 2.5 lakh Gram Panchayats, there is at least one Common Service Center, all right? There's a lot of functions performed by these Common Service Center. We will discuss about it. Right, going into the details is not necessary, but services like even finance, banking, education, healthcare, delivery of government schemes to the beneficiaries, all these exercises are performed by Common Service Centers. All right, if I have to go and get my Aadhaar card renewed or changed, I will go to a Common Service Center, right? Just for an example, right? It aims to serve every citizen. Right, who is the union minister? Who is the union minister of Ministry of Electronics and IT? Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav. Right, Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav. All right, life insurance plans to rural household. Now, the correct answer here, you must have already marked the correct answer here, is Tata AIA Life Insurance. Insurance is very, very important. Insurance is actually a part of financial inclusion. Like life insurance is actually a part of financial inclusion, right? And it is currently rural India mein insurance penetration is still very less at 8 to 10%, as we can see here. All right, so Tata AIA Life Insurance and MeitY has partnered or signed an MOU, in line with the Common Service Center. They will use Common Service Centers to sell life insurance plan to rural people, right? 0.4 million rural entrepreneurs will gain access to 95% of Gram Panchayats. Common Service Centers are now available in Gram Panchayats, as we discussed. So that is why Tata AIA Insurance will use this network of Common Service Center to promote life insurance among the rural people. Alright, so this is what it was about. Usually, you all are reading economics, banking and finance. So tell me more about banking correspondents. right? Banking correspondents are also very, very important people, you know, to help financial inclusion, especially in rural areas. You know, they usually go door to door and sell financial products to people. All right, so here Common Service Center is acting as a banking correspondent, right? It is selling insurance. Where is the headquarters of Binance located? So Binance is actually a major cryptocurrency generating company, right? Earlier it was located in China, but now due to over regulation regarding cryptocurrency in China, it has shifted its headquarters. Now the question is asking you, where is the headquarters, mainly new headquarters of Binance? So this is located in Cayman Islands. Let's have a look at Cayman Islands before we read more about it. Cayman Islands basically are located in Caribbean Sea, but it is a British overseas territory, right? Its sovereign state is the United Kingdoms. It is British overseas territory, right? Cayman Islands, yahan pe Caribbean Sea mein located hai, but the sovereign state is the United Kingdom, right? And this is the new headquarters of this cryptocurrency giant Binance Holding Limited. All right, now why is the question in news, right? Abu Dhabi Global Market se ek in principle approval liya hai to operate as a broker dealer in virtual assets. All right, it is the world's largest cryptocurrency exchange by trading volume, and it was initially based in China, but due to over regulation it shifted its base. All right, so who is it was Changpeng Zhao was the founder of Binance Holding Limited. All right, so this is the logo, just for your information I'm sharing it. This is the headquarter. All right, so what is the interest rate of standing deposit facility of RBI 2022? राइट, स्टैंडिंग डिपॉजिट फैसिलिटी एक अपर सीलिंग लिमिट है. इफ़ यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल इन योर प्रिपरेशन, यू ऑल नो अबाउट द लिक्विडिटी एडजस्टमेंट फैसिलिटी ऑफ द आरबीआई, राइट? सो अपर सीलिंग लिमिट ऑफ लिक्विडिटी, सॉरी, द लोअर सीलिंग लिमिट ऑफ लिक्विडिटी एडजस्टमेंट फैसिलिटी इज स्टैंडिंग डिपॉजिट फैसिलिटी, राइट? व्हेन रिवर्स रेपो रेट कैन नॉट बी यूज्ड बाय बैंक because of the issue of collateral security, standing deposit facility comes into play, right? Standing deposit facility does not need any collateral, right? Function dono ka same hai, reverse repo and standing deposit facility ka. That in both the case scenarios, banks are actually borrowing funds from the central government. All right. So earlier, when in reverse repo, when RBI wants to inject liquidity in the banking system, in reverse repo against government security, a collateral was needed, right? But standing deposit facility, agar banks ke paas, banks don't borrow money from the RBI, when it comes to reverse repo or SDF, they park excess liquidity and excess funds, right, with the Reserve Bank of India. Right, for parking the excess liquidity with the Reserve Bank of India, in that case also banks basically need to purchase government securities if they have to use the reverse repo method, right? But usually when it happened, basically demonetization ke waqt aisa hua tha that banks were flush with money, flush with liquidity, right? But the RBI did not have enough collateral security to absorb the excess liquidity, right? To do away with the need of collateral security in case of excess of liquidity in the banking system, the RBI introduced basically standing deposit facility was introduced by Urijit Patel committee, right? Urijit Patel committee in the year 2014. All right, so basically it totally does away with the need of collateral securities or G-Secs, but there is also like in reverse repo, even though there is no collateral, in that case also banks ko standing deposit facility pe bhi interest rate milta hai. Alright, so this is the issue. And why is it important for banks to park liquid money with the RBI? When banks have an excess of liquidity in their system, in their financial system, why is it important for them to bank that liquid money with the RBI? It is basically important because when there is an excess of liquidity in the money market, the interest rates fall sharply. There is a sharp fall on interest rate, right? So all the money that people have deposited in the banks, the depositors will also earn a low rate of interest, right, in their bank deposits, right? So to keep the money from, to keep the interest rate from falling sharply, you know, it is very important to manage the liquidity, right? Liquidity is also a very important tool in monetary policy transmission. Right, that is why standing deposit facility is one of the most important instruments or innovations by the central bank. You should learn more about it. All right, we have paucity of time, so this was that much I could have explained to you. Right, so the current rate of standing deposit facility is 3.75%. All right, let's have a look at the current rate of standing deposit facility. All right. Ignore the slide, I think it is old. All right, we will discuss about the measures, you know, maybe in the next class, right? The slide will be omitted from the PDF. RBI has introduced standing deposit facility. We have discussed what it is. It is fixed at 3.75%. All right, 3.75% is actually 100 basis point less than the reverse repo rate. Alright, reverse repo rate mein agar standing deposit facility is 3.75%, then the reverse repo rate will be 4.75%. Alright, it will help RBI in absorbing excess liquidity in the market. RBI could borrow money from the banks, right, without giving any collateral in return. Difference hum logon ne already discuss kar liya tha. Reverse repo, usually RBI maintains that the reverse repo should be 100 basis point less than the standing deposit facility, but in this case this is the current rate, right? Why? Because monetary policy abhi RBI ne announced kiya tha that monetary policy is changing its accommodative stand, right? Why? Because inflation has also reached an all-time high. So it is putting inflation before growth now, right? Isse pehle RBI ka accommodative stance tha that it was focusing more on growth and less on inflation. Now that the inflation has reached the upper target limit, almost 6%, it is 5.7% right now. So RBI will target inflation, it will focus on controlling inflation. All right. So it has proposed to make a cardless cash withdrawal facility available across all banks and automated teller machines networks for a unified payment interface. All right, RBI has proposed to lower the net worth requirement for entities to set up bill payment infrastructure. All right, so cardless cash withdrawal, RBI governor, who is the RBI governor? Mr. Shaktikant Das. Right, Mr. Shaktikant Das is the RBI governor, and he has introduced that more cardless cash withdrawal facilities will be introduced in banks. Cardless cash withdrawal ke basic benefits kya ho jayenge? Cardless cash withdrawal se, you know, jo ATM frauds hote hai, like card skimming and card cloning, these will be reduced to a great extent, right? So lower the net worth requirement for entities to set up bill payment infrastructure through Bharat bill payment system from rupees 100 crore to rupees 25 crore. All right, so this is the issue. This is the main thing over here. SDF hum logo ne padhi liya tha. Isi tarah marginal standing facility jo hamara hai. Marginal standing facility is the upper limit of the LAF corridor, right? LAF corridor कैसे work करता है? LAF corridor basically सबसे पहले आपका marginal standing facility आ गया, then you have your repo rate, right? Repurchase agreement option, then you have reverse repo, right? And now you have your SDF facility. All right, this is your FDA corridor. All right, so marginal standing facility basically it wants the banks to you know, borrow money from the RBI, right? They want to sell. So marginal standing facility also, it is set 100 basis point above the repo rate, so that, you know, borrowing money, you know, becomes a little costly, right? And basically interbank liquidity jab bhi crisis mein, usually banks, you know, use the repo rate only. Primary preference is always given to repo rate, but suppose there is an emergency crisis, right, and the interbank liquidity dries up, that is the banks cannot borrow from each other, then marginal standing facility can be used. All right, marginal standing facility, by the way, was first introduced in 2011. Who heads SEBI's committee? I hope this was very, very fruitful to you. Whatever I have told you, it helped. All right, in case you have any doubts regarding any of these criteria, just let me know down in the comments below. All right, who heads SEBI's committee on mutual fund trustee? SEBI committee mutual fund trustee ke head kaun hai? Answer the question. You have Manoj Vaish, R.K. Suman, Srivats Sanjay, Arun Srivastav, Pankaj Kumar Devrani. Right, so the correct answer is Manoj Vaish, independent trustee of Mirae Mutual Fund. All right, mutual fund trustee. So SEBI basically, it has formed two working groups. All right, it wants to review the role and eligibility of the sponsors of a mutual fund. Right, mutual fund, you all know, these are also very important instruments, right? These are, you know, at an all-time high, right? Mutual fund subscriptions are at an all-time high, right? The financial penetration of mutual funds today is exemplary in the market. All right, so isi ke liye SEBI have formed two working groups to review the role and eligibility of a sponsor of a mutual fund. All right, so first group is on sponsors, and second group is on trustees, right? Whoever sponsors and whoever is the trustee of a mutual fund, SEBI basically wants to review their role and eligibility, right? So sponsor ke jo chairperson hai, he is Mr. A Balasubramaniam, who is the MD and CEO of Aditya Birla Sun Life AMC. And second group is on trustees, who is Mr. Manoj Vaish. All right, independent trustee of Mirae Mutual Funds. Last but the most important question for today, which bank has launched Vikas Siri Sampath 1111, a new deposit scheme? Vikas Siri Sampath, ek new deposit scheme hai, aur wo kaun se bank ne launch kara hai? Please answer the question correctly. You have options: Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank, PNB, Canara, Bank of Maharashtra and Karur Vyas Bank. The correct answer here is Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank. Right, Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank is chaired by Mr. P. Gopi Krishna, right? And he has launched Vikas Siri Sampath scheme. It is a new deposit scheme of the bank, right? Jisme general public ko 5.7% interest rate diya jayega. Ek deposit scheme hai, right, where people can park their funds for these many days with an interest rate of 5.7 and 6.2%. Of course, iska basic bahut important outcome kya hoga? Financial inclusion, right? Financial empowerment of the people, you know, financing the underserved and the unserved section of the society, right? Annualized return is 6.03% hai, right? For senior citizens, obviously it is high. Minimum amount is 10,000 and maximum amount is 2 crore, right? Very, very important banking project, banking initiative by Karnataka Vikas Grameen Bank, chaired by Mr. P. Gopi Krishna. All right, so this was it for today. I hope the lecture, the session was useful. Right, thank you so much for watching. In case you have any doubts, do let me know in the comments below. Right, take care. See you in the next class.